I wasn't grumpy.
I was.
I was angry.
It's lovely to meet you both, and congrats on the film.
Thank you.
So Henry V was around the same age as you, Timothee, when he ascended the throne. If you could both be transported back in time and be king, what rules would you put in place?
Oh, wow.
Yeah. You'd think I'd have a prepared answer
for
this,
make the decree that 600 years from now, when there's a director named David Michod alive, that all his movies be masterpieces, received as masterpieces.
Yeah, really.
I would decree that, I'm actually going to be serious now, decree that like people be forced to listen to scientific consensus and actually do some, I cannot believe that all of these years later that we're still pretending there's a debate to be had.
Yeah.
Very intelligent answer.
Like 600 years ago.
Way more intelligent.
Yeah, that was when we
He tried.
I tossed up a token of admiration to my director.
Yeah.
And he slammed me down. No.
There's a line in the film which is, the king has only followers, not friends. Mm. Timothee, you've got millions of followers. Mm. You're known as the internet's boyfriend. Mm. Do you ever feel like the king?
No. I feel like the jester. The royal court's jester.
So we don't need to bow down to you or anything?
No, I think that'd be very weird. Whenever that happens, that doesn't happen. Whenever in life, even on set sometimes, like somebody might have to help you with your costume or whatever, I match the play, I'll match the physical station of someone else.
What I loved about this film was how much significance a ball played, which Henry V obviously received as a present. Mm. What's the strangest gift you've ever received? There's a laugh there.
No, I'm remembering Brad Pitt sent me a Christmas hamper a couple of years ago.
A Christmas hamper?
Yeah.
Like a laundry hamper?
Well, just a box full of weird Christmas stuff.
Oh,
I actually don't want to talk about what was in it.
Oh, that's so much cooler than anything I could say.
It was funny.
I didn't get a box from Brad Pitt.
Yeah, there you go. I managed to name drop big time.
I don't know what the weirdest gift is.
Have you ever given someone a weird gift, like a prank?
Like a prank gift? Yeah. Yes, absolutely. I guess I'm personalityless. I can't.
Knock yourself like that.
The room's turning, so I'm losing sight now.
So we'll move on to sword fighting there's some serious sword fighting skills in this. What's the trick to it then?
I don't know, practice makes perfect, and getting the opportunity to work on a movie that lets you live your 12-year-old boy's dream out and just get to rehearse all the time, swing a sword around, get to feel like a knight. But seriously, no, I work with there's a stunt coordinator on this movie named Steve Dent. He has a company named Steve Dent Stunts right outside of London, and I was on that farm every day and working hard and working on fights. Sometimes I didn't make it into the movie because they didn't fit the style of the movie, but I literally still have them committed to memory to this day.
And it's probably worth your while, actually.
Yeah, totally.
It's something, these young guys, even sort of young men of nobility, would have trained to fight, and they would have aspired to do so. And so, you get out in the battlefield, it's kind of good to have those moves in your muscle memory, but then, once you're in the thick of it, you just trying to stay alive.
There's some scenes where Henry V struggles to get out of bed in the morning.
Mm.
Could you relate to that? Are you a morning person?
It depends on the day. I've had great mornings.
What about today?
I've also had, we had our premiere last night.
Yeah.
So was it one of those days this morning then?
I wasn't grumpy.
I was
angry.
No, okay.
Well, I hope you're not angry.
No, I'm super grateful. Were you there last night or no?
I was, yeah.
That was
amazing.
Really great time.
And it was fun.
And it's a relief, we made a bunch of Australians and American and Robert Pattinson's English, and we had some great English actors in it, but a precarious number of Australians and Americans too. And we're doing a story from one of the great figures of British history, so it was nerve-wracking to bring it here because we could have gotten killed.
That would not have been good.
That would not have been good.
Well, I'm glad that you haven't been killed.
Thank you.
And it's been an absolute pleasure chatting
to you
both.
Thank you
so much.